Hello and welcome all. I'm Abhishek Tiwari and you're watching me on Unplugged TV India. It is time to take a look at another updates doing round across the country as India is all set to roll out booster doses for healthcare workers, frontline warriors and persons with 60 plus age with comorbidities. The center on Tuesday cleared two more vaccines, Corbivax and Covovax. These two vaccines will be launched along with antiviral drug called Molnupiravir, which can be used during emergencies. Corbivax is said to be the first homegrown RBD protein subunit vaccine, which is manufactured by a Hyderabad-based firm, Biological E, while Covovax is made by a nanoparticle vaccine, which will be manufactured by Serum Institute of India. Union Health Ministry also informed that 60% plus with comorbidities won't have to submit any certificate from the doctors at the time of administration of the precautionary dose. Amid the growing tension regarding manhandling doctors while protesting on December 27 in Delhi, Resident Doctors Association have decided to take back their decision of strike after meeting health officials. Now it has been decided that all services will be continued as normal. The Union Health Minister on Tuesday met the resident doctors. In a meeting, it was assured that the NEET PG 2021 counselling will begin soon. Earlier, Federation of India Medical Association called for a complete withdrawal of services across the country on December 29. The harsh decision was taken when a peaceful protest of doctors was disturbed by obscene brutality by police personnel on December 27 in Delhi. It is informed that while protesting, few doctors were brutally thrashed while some were detained by the cops. The resident doctors have been protesting against the delay in the PG counseling process. The counseling process was supposed to begin from October 25th, but the same has not been done. Due to the delay in NEET PG counseling process, resident doctors have to work overtime due to the staff shortage. The resident doctors alleged that they are being forced to work for over 80 hours in a week. 2021 has not only been bad for humans, but has been bad for the wildlife as well. This year, 31 tigers and 82 humans were killed in Maharashtra in wildlife attacks. The year 2021 proved to be brutal for not only humans but for tigers and leopards as well. The deaths of tigers and leopards have gone up to 31 and 161 respectively, while that of human beings to 82 in wildlife attacks. Recently, the man-animal conflicts have been rising. The rise in attack has become a headache for the forest officials. Chandrapur recorded the highest number of deaths of humans in wildlife attacks. Chandrapur alone recorded 65% of tiger attacks death of humans. Meanwhile, 8 persons were killed in tiger attack at Tadoba Adheri Tiger Reserve. 7 deaths were registered in Gadchiroli, 6 in FDCM area of Gadchiroli, while 3 in Nagpur district and 2 in Yavatmal. Apart from this, 24 persons were killed in leopard attack in Maharashtra this year. Nasik registered highest number of 9 deaths due to leopard attacks, followed by 7 deaths in Chandrapur. Moreover, there are 2 deaths by wild boar attacks and 1 death in elephant attack in Chandrapur. Meanwhile, Nagpur district recorded 2 deaths due to leopard attack. Till date, the Forest Department has disbursed ₹12.30 crores to the family members of 82 deceased persons. The department registered a figure of 31 tiger deaths this year, including T-35 tigress that was found dead in Salegaht Forest Range under Penched Tiger Reserve on Tuesday. Of the total deaths of tigers, 18 are said to be natural, 4 by poisoning, 2 by electrocution, 2 by poaching, and 1 by accident. Last year, 18 tiger deaths were recorded, while in the year 2018-19, 22 deaths were recorded. Brazil's Bahia has been hit by the worst disaster of the state. The death toll from the hammering of northeast Brazil rose to 20 on Monday, as the government of Bahia state declared the worst disaster in the state's history and rescuers braced for more rain in coming days. Bahia, a home to about 15 million people, have suffered from the intermittent flooding for weeks. Flooding in some areas were intensified late on Christmas Eve and early on Christmas Day as a pair of dams gave way, sending residents scrambling for higher ground. Rescue workers patrolling in small dinghies around the city of Itabuna in southern Bahia, plucking residents from their home, including some who escaped from the second floor windows. Bahia's civil defense agency said that 20 people lost their life in 11 municipalities. Hong Kong health authorities on Tuesday informed that they would be tightening quarantine rules for air cargo crew to tackle the ongoing threat of Omicron virus. The global financial hub intensified several dozens of Omicron cases via regular testing during quarantine, but neither Omicron nor other variants have spread into the community in recent months, while some of the new infections with Omicron were detected in air crew. According to the new measures, before returning to home quarantine, air cargo crew have to spend 3 days in hotel quarantine. If you like our content, then please hit like, share and subscribe to our channel. Help us grow more to provide you more details, facts and daily updates. Till then, good night.